It's important to keep your website organized, both at the front end for people who are viewing it and at the back end for yourself, so you don't end up in a bit of a twist. And that is what categories are going to be able to help you do. Think of it like organizing your closet. You have all of these different clothes, but you're going to organize everything by shoes, shirts, pants, so that it's easy to find, easy to remember, and you don't get messed up. For your WordPress page, you might want to organize things into topics like news, opinions, and sport. Again, good for you, good for your readers, good for your viewers, wins for everybody. I'm James, this is WP Beginner. Do like the video and get subscribed so that you can pick up more quick wins just like this to make your WordPress journey that little bit easier. So back to our categories. By default, WordPress assigns uncategorized to anything that you put up that doesn't have a category. But don't worry, we will show you how to change that a little bit later. Adding a category to your post is actually really, really easy. It's just checking a box. You just have to remember to do it. Check a box from the list that's there, or if there isn't a category you want, create one and check that box. It's really that simple, and it can save you a ton of time and headaches. If you want to add subtopics under those broader topics that we were mentioning earlier, for example, news, and you can have a subtopic of maybe local, national, weather, you can create what's known as a child category. So we're going to go to the posts and then the categories screen, and then we're going to select a parent category from the drop-down menu. Fill in the name for your child category, and then there's a couple of other boxes there you can fill in if you want to, which are the description and the slug. It's entirely up to you if you want to put information in there. And we've gone from organized to super organized with our news topics. We now have news, and on top of that, we have global news. So we really are starting to get organized and make our lives nice and easy. Now, this is obviously great for us, but I did mention that this could be really good for the people who are visiting your site as well. And all you have to do is add your categories to your page, and it's really easy to do. You can add categories to the sidebar or even add them to your website's navigation menu. If you want to display your categories in the sidebar, you can do so with a widget. You're going to go to categories, and then you're going to go to widgets. You then drag and drop the categories widget into the sidebar, and all your categories will be displayed except the ones that don't have posts. Again, super easy. If you select the show hierarchy option, then you're going to get to see all of your child categories as well. So nice and organized and easy for you, nice and organized and easy for the people visiting your site. One last thing we want to touch on is that we do not want to get confused between categories and tags. The easiest way to look at it is a category is like a book. It's chapters in a book, whereas a tag is the index in the back. A category is a whole broad range of things that fall under it, and a tag is a very specific thing that you have tagged into something. So that one word is what's going to show up. It's far more specific, like an index. Of course, categories aren't the only way for you to be able to keep your content organized and visually appealing. One of the best ways is to use a page builder, which is going to allow you to design every single page on your website exactly as you would like it. We'd highly recommend checking out Seed Prod, and if you want to see a tutorial on how to use that, then click this video right here.